everybody. How you doing? This is Damon, Cigar Review TV. Getting ready to smoke a cigar. It's not going to be a, it's going to be kind of a check-in. Hello. And, going to be smoking a Heisenberg. Believe it or not, this is the Heisenberg. And it says Heisenberg on there, but can't really read it. Can't really talk about it much because there's really not a lot to talk about with this actual cigar because they don't know if they ever will. They haven't put out any information on it. They want it to kind of be something more where cigar aficionados will sit back and smoke a cigar and take in the taste and the flavors based on what they taste, not based on what they read about. So, as far as the kind of tobacco, you know, so, there we go. Look it up, Heisenberg. Let's look up Heisenberg cigar, and you'll see it. I don't know how available they are, or whatever, so, you can see. That's the reason why I'm not really reviewing it too much. Other than just getting a quick little say hello to everybody, I also wanted to say happy Thanksgiving if you are indulging in Thanksgiving at all. You know, for people like me, being able to smoke a cigar, eat decent meals, that kind of thing, have a job, got a lot to be thankful for. You know, I know a lot of people are not in that same position. Some people are in a much better situation, but there are a lot of people that are in dire situations. Don't even have shelter, don't even have a meal that they know that they can count on. So I'm extremely, extremely grateful for all the little and big things that I have in my life. And so happy Thanksgiving, everybody. And I'm going to relax tonight because it's been a very busy week. I'm in the middle of moving. This will be the last little hurrah from this little hole that I'm in here. My surroundings will be different from now on with my reviews. And we'll see how that all, where I go and how it works out with that. But, so I'll be looking forward to the move. I hate moving, but, it's definitely a step up, so I'm looking forward to it. Got really, real, quite a grassy, a little bit of a grassy taste to it, along with the just that regular tobacco taste, you know. Very smoky, nutty taste to me, but got a lot of grassy type hints of stuff to me in there. And the Heisenberg. Can't remember size. I don't know if it says the size on here or not. Yes, it is. It's a 5x48. And it is already kind of the ash. Not holding a good ash. It's smoking okay. The draw is nice. It's got a nice draw. And do. Yeah, anyway, moving is good, and moving up, moving on, moving around, all that kind of crap. Hate the actual part of moving, but, you know, it's for a few hours, then it's done, so not that bad. Here in Arizona, the weather's been very nice. You know, I talk about the weather just about every time I do something, and still riding the bike, that kind of thing in the morning, and it is not as cold as it was last year. Last year I froze quite a lot. This year so far it's been in the mid to high 40s lately, still being able to wear shorts. I wear a jacket and even wore a pair of gloves the other day because it was like 42. It was a little bit chilly with the wind and all that right on your hands. But busy week, lots of, you know, all the different stuff going on, so. What's it, I think, been about almost 2 weeks since my last review. And so I wanted to at least poke my head in and say hello, see how everybody's doing. See a lot of different things tail off from different people, either tweeting or Facebooking or whatever, and I'm one of them. They haven't done a whole lot of tweeting. They haven't done a review video or whatever for the last couple weeks. So the busy season or the silly season kind of takes everybody's time, which is good because you can get away from the other bullshit. One thing I did want to talk about real quickly. This last week we had an anniversary of our President John F. Kennedy and of him being murdered in the streets. And broad daylight in front of people, cameras, everything. And we know the story that we're taught in school. We know the story that only about 10% of Americans actually believe, and we know the all the different other parts of the story, at least a lot of us do, and it blows me away and opens the eyes all at the same time to see that all the different mainstream news stations put on these different specials, and it's all about Lee Harvey Oswald killing JFK. Now, I don't know if any of you out there believe that or whatever. That's your deal, whatever. But do a little bit of research. Be interested. If you know all the actual facts, it is impossible to believe. Not only that, but the last things that were put in the books, in the courts, and I don't know how long it took them to do it, to put it in there, but to actually come up and say, yes, the probability of there being a conspiracy within our own country to kill our president is a high probability. They did not come out and say, yeah. But that's on the books. So for all of our mainstream news is trying to tell her, keep the lie alive from 1963, you know, with all the facts that have already come out, that are known facts. I know a lot of people don't delve into the different shit like that and look at it, read it. I ended up getting really interested in it one time, about 15 years ago, and started reading these books, and looking at the different things with the autopsy, and it's impossible, completely impossible to, you know, for him to have been shot, first of all, by just the one guy. And in order for that to have all happened, just in case somebody doesn't know, had to have been one bullet that went through two people, went through bone, and came out completely unscathed and fell out on a stretcher in the hospital. So, I guess physics, you know, doesn't really matter. So anyway, that really bothered me, and it also kind of woke me up to make sure to not trust at all anything I see on the actual mainstream news. If they're still telling the lie, if they're still keeping the lie alive of the murder of one of our presidents, then what else are they told to tell us, or what else are they trying to, you know? So I don't trust them at all, and I don't really, the news comes on in my place because I have roommates and they'll watch, but I go get your news elsewhere. Anyway, that was my biggest gripe. The cigar is okay. I don't remember how much I paid for it. I didn't know it was not that much. It might have been about $6 or something like that, if I remember right. Hopefully it wasn't much more than that. It's got a... It's okay. It's a medium-bodied cigar right now. Smoking okay. It's got, like I said, it's got a very nice draw. It's okay. It's not my end-all, be-all favorite, but it's not bad. It's just okay. Yeah, see, I'm just sitting here, and it just completely fell off right into my lap. I was literally holding it like this, and it just fell off. So, it doesn't hold an ash, which, you know, that's part of it, but a little bit of a bite, and not a, like a good bite, like a bitterness to it. So, there we go. A little bit about that, just a little bit of a hello to anybody. I hope everybody's doing well. I hope everybody's going to have a decent little holiday-ish time or whatever, and kind of get it over with and get on with our lives, you know? So everybody, hope everybody's doing well. I'll be seeing you probably in a week or two. I'm going to do the move and stuff like that, so we'll see how soon after the move that I get another video going. I hope you're doing well. Take care. Bye-bye.